Thank you. who likes to be rejected. Nobody likes to feel in themselves as if they are cast off. Nobody likes to feel as if they are pushed to the back. Nobody likes to feel unwanted. Everybody in this building here today always want to know that you are appreciated and find yourself in a position where you feel that you're highlighted. There is no one, I guarantee you, absolutely no one who wants to feel as if they are at the back of the mountain, praise God. And even if there's somebody here today who is saying to themselves, well, I don't need nobody and I can do it all by myself, I guarantee you, somewhere in that person's life, at some point in time, they have probably been hurt, and because of that hurt, they have built up some form of defense mechanism in order to help them to push through. Well, you're with me, church. But then we understand that it is a natural process in life, a natural part of life, to be in a position where you're going to be rejected at some point in time in your life. Are you with me, everybody? We look at the Lord and we look at Jesus's life and we realize that even him, I've said it before, that Jesus, there are three aspects in his life that all of us are going to have to experience while we are walking with God, and you know them. We've said that Jesus was in his period of obscurity, and that's a period in Jesus's life when nobody knew him, nobody knew about what he was capable of doing, nobody knew that he could work miracles, nobody knew that he was a healer. He was just the son of Mary and Joseph. Are you with me, somebody? Then he moved and he transitioned into another part of his life where after he done the miracle, praise God Almighty, then everybody knew Jesus because now he was in his period of popularity and everybody knew the master. And so there were many who traveled from far and near in order to be in Jesus' company. At one time, there was a group of people, an entire group of people who the leaves of the palm trees and they put them down on the ground and they hailed Jesus and said, Hosanna, blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. But can I tell you that there is something that we need to understand, that for every time when we are hailed, for every time when we are lifted up, there's coming a period of time when we are going to be rejected. Are you with me, somebody? Because the very same people who hailed Jesus, the very same people who said Hosanna, were the very same ones a few days later who were now shouting that they should crucify him. Are you with me, everybody? And so the Bible tells us that Jesus was in all points tempted as we are. In other words, he experienced it first. So whatever you are going through, he experienced it. So Jesus knows what it feels like to love somebody but finding them don't love you. He knows what it feels like to want to uplift somebody but then finding them have no concern about you whatsoever. And so Jesus was rejected. Can I tell you that all of us are going to experience rejection in our lives? But God tears us down in order to build us up. That is how God does what he does. He has a way of just tearing us away, moving us away from everybody, and then in the darkness, then in the silence, he has a way of just building, molding, and putting us together. Are you with me, somebody? Before Jesus could have started his ministry, he had to go into the wilderness in order to fast and to be tempted. I
want to tell somebody that when you are going to experience God, you're going to experience Him by yourself. It's not based on somebody's testimony. It's not based on somebody's experience, but you've got to experience God for yourself. So come here, Brother Moses. Yes, you're next in line to be Pharaoh. You're next in line to rule in Egypt. But God's got a greater job for you. How can it be that God's got something greater when Moses was royalty, walking up and down in Egypt and being on top? But here God comes and dismantles Moses, his life. He rips him away from his prized possession. Moses is now on the backside of a mountain and is now a shepherd. That doesn't add up to me. How can you move him away from being prince to being a little shepherd? But God has a way of tearing you down in order to build you up. Not everything that happens negatively in your life, it means it's a devil. It means that God is getting ready to elevate somebody. It means that God is getting ready to promote somebody. But before you can go up, then you gotta go down. Somebody open your mouth and give God some glory. I want to tell you something. Don't depend on those who you see every day to see what is in you. Many of us will get hurt because we're expecting our brothers and sisters. We're expecting our friends to see the greatness in us. But that's where we made a mistake. Stop looking for those who are with you to see the brightness that be inside you. Jesus was in Nazareth for over 30 years, but then the Bible tells us that he could not do much miracles where he lived, because when Jesus' ministry started, they say, "Is this not Mary's son? Is this not the carpenter boy? Am I talking to the church?" Stop looking for friends to see your greatness. Stop looking for those who are around you to see the greatness that's within you, because they're the ones who sometimes end up hurting you the most. Are you with somebody? Your brothers are the very same ones who are gonna say, "Here comes the dreamer." Can I talk to somebody? When God has got an anointing up on your life, it's gonna be too much for some people. Can I tell you, it's not that there's something wrong with you, why some people can't stand you. It's just that your anointing is too big for where they are. Your anointing is too great. And so don't look on their bad face negatively. It means that there's something in you that's more. Can I talk to somebody? I heard a little fable about an eagle, and it's shared that an eagle, it once got lost, a baby eagle if you will, and it got lost by its mother, and then a duck, oh God, found that eagle and started to raise the eagle as its own. And so you know, ducks, they walk in one line, and every one is behind mama. And when they're in the pond, everybody is behind mama. And it's pond to the land. And then the thing is, you never see ducks soaring and going high. Are you with me, somebody? They were always down in the swamps. Are you with me, somebody? But here comes the eagle. He was in line with mommy in the pond on the earth. In the pond on the earth. But then there was something in him that he could not understand. There was something in him that he could not explain. Because while he was in the pond, he felt like he could soar above the clouds. While he was in the pond, he felt like his wings needed to be spread a bit more. He looked at himself. He looked at mommy. He looked at his brothers. He realized his wings were bigger. His beak looked different. And while they were comfortable being in the pond, the eagle wanted to soar. The eagle had to leave the pond and fly. Can I tell somebody, don't let nobody stop you from soaring. Don't let nobody stop you from flying. Why be a dog when God made you to be an eagle? Somebody give him glory. Somebody give him glory. Somebody give him glory. Somebody open your mouth and give him praise. Tell somebody soar. Tell somebody soar. Tell somebody fly. Tell somebody fly. Tell somebody get up. Get up. Out of the pond. You're an eagle. You're an eagle. You're an eagle. You're Holy Ghost. We have one ready to baptize. We have one, send them one baptize. Come on, we have one, we have one, we have one. Come on, we have one who's ready to be baptized. Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost.
Brother Michael Murphy. From the authority given to me by the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
And as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I now therefore baptize you in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins, and you too shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost.
So I want you to welcome everybody. The new Brother Michael Murphy. Come on, baby, welcome. Come on, baby.